Bonjour, my name is Olivier, and this is your wine rendezvous. Crucial question today. When a wine smells like raspberry, do they really put raspberry in it? That's a question I get a lot from my clients. So clearly, here what you need to be aware of is that, first, I really want you to be very relaxed about this, okay? Don't stress out, like, I'm not sure I can identify the citrus, the raspberry, the gooseberry, my grandma's barn or something. So here, just relax. And be aware that most people who seem very good at this, usually they just cheat. You open any wine-related book and you read Sauvignon Blanc, citrusy, Chardonnay, it's buttery, banana. Cabernet Sauvignon is a bit like black currant and green pepper, so on. So next time you drink a Cabernet, you can go, maybe a little note of green pepper. So it's just all BS. So really, don't worry about it too much. But the crucial question that I ask initially is, do they really put raspberry into this? It's a question that most people won't dare asking, but it's actually a pretty good question. The answer is no. Why? In wine, you find three types of aromas. You find the first type, which is called primary aromas, which are actually the grape variety aromas. I mean, each grape variety will bring about aromas of XYZ, so Sauvignon Blanc, we said citrus, Chardonnay, butter, currants for Cabernet Sauvignon, and so on and so forth. Okay, that's the basis. And then on top of this, you have your secondary aromas, called also the fermentation aromas, meaning during fermentation, we saw that sugar will turn into alcohol, boom, CO2 is released in the process, there you have it, wine. But during this whole little fermentation stage, there's a molecular mess on this excitement. If you go on the barrel, you hear it's kind of loud, it makes bubbles, and there's obviously some action, chemical action going on, so there's a molecular reconstruction. So when you say wine smells like raspberry, there's no raspberry added to it. What happens is that there's a molecule that is the exact same one as the one you find in raspberry, so it ends up smelling the same, but it's all chemistry in the end, okay? So that's, we have our two basic family of aromas, and then as your wine gets older, okay, as it's going to breathe, and therefore as the oxygen is going to come in through the cork of the bottle, well, the oxygen will come in and will oxidize the wine. So new aromas will slowly take over as the wine gets older, and those are called the maturation aromas. Okay, maturation, your wine gets older, new things take over, those musty aromas, leather, smoke, tobacco, all these will tend to come with a bit of age. Okay, so basically we have our three aromas, grape variety, fermentation, and maturation, and then it's specific to each wine. Each wine has its own little combination of aromas. One more thing: if you want to get to these very aromas, and if you haven't read all these books or these websites that will tell you blah blah blah, Sauvignon Blanc, citrusy, and so on and so forth, the technique. What's the technique? The technique is to try and think in terms of family. Okay, so to start with the broad families. And try to narrow it down a bit, like in a funnel. So if you do it, I don't know, if you take a random wine, okay, is it animal, is it mineral, is it fruity, is it floral? This wine, I think it's quite fruity. Oh, you break it down. You think it's light color fruit, dark color fruit, is it white, yellow, or red, black? Here, obviously, no berries, so white, yellow, boom, white, yellow fruit. We can become a bit more creative. Maybe citrusy, and then when... Okay, citrus, yeah, okay, so you can go, boom, grapefruit, green apple, lime, all these will come naturally. But it's just a matter of trying to give them a frame to your thoughts, because it's all the olfactory memory, which is a memory you pretty much never use, so, voila, the more you work on it, the better you'll become at it. But basically, just relax, there's no need for this to enjoy your wine, which is what I'm going to do right now. Cheers to you, to good wine, to a good life, and I look forward to seeing you very shortly on winerendezvous.com. Santé. Au revoir.